How's it going, everybody? Welcome back to Prison Architect. Welcome back to Prison Architect Gangs, and welcome back to Prison Architect Free for Life, which is the latest expansion to Prison Architect. We talked about that in the last episode, and it turns out I'm a little bit of an idiot, because the option for older prisoners isn't enabled by default. So I had to go in and I had to turn that on, and I have done that now. So if we go in and we take a look, we might be able to find an older prisoner, such as this one right here, Paul McKenzie. He is 63, and if we hover over him, we can see that he is a senior. If we go to Lawrence here, for example, Matt Lawrence, 29, he is considered young. And if we go to Stephen Wilders, he's also, I believe, considered to be young. Whereas Benjamin Lovegrove, age 60, is considered to be senior. So we do now have some senior prisons in here. Prisons? Prisoners. Inmates in here. The thing is, we can't necessarily categorize them that way. We can't put seniors in one place and all that, as I think I've talked about before. But that's okay. I'm not really too worried about that. What I'm worried about today is turning my attention to this side of the map, because I think what I want to do is get to work on both a supermax and a protective custody facility, or, well, two facilities. And I think the way I'm going to do that is I'm going to go into quick build, and I'm going to go to custom, and I'm going to clone all of this space. Now, this is not going to be super creative to begin with, but that's okay, because my plan is that whilst the admin space is going to be symmetrical, the space back here isn't. We're going to have, similar to this, we're going to have a big road that leads up to the prisons, except it's going to split. We're going to have one go to the top, one go to the bottom, and that's going to be the way we separate supermax and protective custody. But for now, let's just go ahead and do this for about $200,000. Now, that's a lot of construction. That is a lot of things that my workers need to do. And I'm going to be honest, I'm a little bit nervous about this. I also wonder, no, I did get it lined up. I am a little bit nervous about this because it does mean that for a while, this perimeter wall isn't going to exist. And as such, my prisoners could, in theory, get out these doors and make a break for it. So, thinking about it, it might not be a terrible idea to go in and get myself another sniper tower, or tower, I think it's called guard tower. That's the official term. Sniper tower might be a little bit too aggressive, but we'll put a guard tower right there and right there if I can. I don't know if it's going to let me. There we go. And I think what we'll also do is put a guard tower right up here, and we'll put another one just a way down here as well. Again, if it's going to let me, which it is. I also want to prioritize those, because I think getting these in would be a really good idea, and I think I might need to get some more snipers for these as well. But installing those should mean that prisoners generally can't make a break for it, because when all of this is built, the only place they're going to be able to go will be through the gates, which will have sniper towers or guard towers on either side. And so while all of that's going on, I want to go ahead and turn my attention back to the main section of our prison so far, because I want to take a look at prisoner needs. And it seems like exercise is kind of a big one, which is interesting because they do get yard time. It seems family is kind of a big one, and comfort as well. So prisoners generally want to feel comfortable physically and emotionally. There are many ways you can do this, such as allowing family visitations, giving them hot showers, or simply making sure they have somewhere to sit. So, I almost wonder if adding another common room would be a good idea, because I feel like another common room would be a way to just let them chill a little bit during free time. I mean, some of them are going to this common room here, some of them are already over here, but I'm just wondering if it would be worth giving them another one. And especially considering it might split the gangs up a little bit. Oh, we have a gang meeting going on right here. That's a little bit concerning. Yeah, all involved in gang business. Are you a leader? You do strike me as someone that... Hold on a minute. Let's go to intelligence. Let's go to gangs. Oh, I think you are... You're like a lieutenant, right? Oh, we got a little meeting going on over here as well. Do I maybe want to lock up my... My gang lieutenants as well? Because... Oh. Now, what are you... Are you... That's a new leader. I guess... Now, didn't we put... I don't remember who it was, but didn't we at one point... Was it Hawkins here? Are you currently on... What are you on right now? I don't know if you're on permanent solitary or not. Let's see. Solitary? No, you're not. Are you on permanent solitary? No. Okay. We did put some people on permanent solitary, though, didn't we? It was specifically gang leaders were put on permanent solitary. Yeah, so James Dummer, for example, is a gang leader and is... on permanent solitary. But what's interesting is I'm almost certain, put another one of these guys on permanent solitary who is no longer a gang leader by the looks of it. I thought it might have been Hawkins, but I guess not. So I suppose what we'll do is we'll go to gangs, we'll go to Ranger here, who is supposed to be on permanent solitary, so never mind. So that gang leader is on his way there eventually. But I wonder if going and grabbing some lieutenants and saying that you are going into permanent solitary, I mean, this might annoy the gangs, but I imagine it might help me out a little bit as well. We'll do the same with Kroger. We'll go ahead and send you to permanent solitary. And I believe Mead here was the other one I was looking for. Yeah, so Andrew Mead is also going to permanent solitary. And so doing that, we should see gangs maybe chill out a little bit. I kind of doubt it. Wait, did this guy... Why do I get the feeling that this guy just had free rein to go and do something? I'm not really sure. I'm not really sure what happened there, but that's... Well, fair enough, I guess. Uh-oh. Oh, there it is. Hold on a minute. Are we going to be able to deal with this? We have a few guards coming in. It looked... Yeah, we're dealing with it. I don't know if any guards died during this. I also, I'm pretty sure one of my cats was barking right there, so fair enough. That was a pretty tame riot compared to what we've had to deal with before, so not too concerned about it. And obviously the priority remains building this, but I mean, while that's going on, we do kind of need to make sure that the main prison itself is at least doing okay. And to be honest, one way I think we could maybe make sure this place is okay is by going and building another yard. I don't think it would be a terrible idea to get a second one up here and then also a second one down here as well, because it does mean that the prisoners will have more options for exercise equipment. It means that the gangs will be spread out a little bit further between all of the different yards. And hopefully that's going to result in them being a little bit more chill. I don't know if it will, obviously. It might, this might not work at all, but I'm willing to give it a shot. I'm willing to see what happens. We'll put an entrance right there. We'll go ahead and put an entrance right there. And I suppose we could put an entrance. Let's see. Where do I want to put an entrance to this thing? I guess it doesn't really matter. I suppose we could just put it sort of opposite the other one, right? So you can go through the yard if you really want to. And then down at this end, we'll do exactly the same thing right there. Now, what I'm thinking with this tail on these new yards is we could probably put some bathrooms down here. So if I go to planning and I say, you know, give me some walls here, I can do a little something something just like this, just the entire way across. And we'll go up until about there in line with this fence at the top. We can go across like this, and what we can do is actually completely wall this off if we want to. Although I'm not too sure I want to do that, because if I have guards patrolling here, they're going to have to go in there. Which, well, I suppose that's okay. Yeah, I guess we'll do this for the toilets, and that'll be fine. I might even put a door at this end of things, because then, well... No, I don't think we will do that. We'll keep this end sort of closed off. So that's going to be the idea for the toilets, which means if we go up this way, we want a wall going like this with all these little parts just not right there, but just like this. And I suppose what I can do is I can just copy and paste this design minus the wall section there, and then just build it up here. Now, this is going to take a while to build because obviously my workers are all going to be busy with the new building, but I think that's okay. And I think what we'll do here is we'll go ahead and use the reclaimed wood because I think it looks pretty great. And we'll just build ourselves sort of a little outhouse. Little isn't necessarily the right word here, but we'll build ourselves kind of an outhouse. That's also the first time in a long time I've seen a prisoner using the communal showers. That's weird. It's been a minute since we've seen that. Oh, so it turns out my workers are actually getting to work pretty quickly down here, which is pretty good news. And I'm also looking at this weird sort of little corridor we're going to have, and I'm thinking that maybe we should do possibly a staff gate down there. I don't really see a reason prisoners would be up this way. So we'll do a staff gate right about there, and we'll do a staff gate right about there. And at the very least, that's going to let my staff sort of get through to do what they got to do. So we'll see how that goes. We'll see if that ends up being a good thing. Hopefully this all gets built in no time at all. We do have toilets placed. We have drains placed. Obviously the pipes have been placed as well. So it's just a case of building this, getting the paths in there, and then putting in things to make it a yard. And hopefully that's going to cheer the prisoners up a little bit. And hopefully they're going to stop murdering each other, because, I mean, there's been a couple down here. There's a fourth one as well, which is a little bit worrying. But hopefully we can continue to bring the number of deaths per day at this prison down a little bit, because it's still a little bit too high. Admittedly, it's obviously not as bad as it once was, but it's still up there a little bit, and I'm still not, I'm not thrilled about it, to put it lightly. I really wish they would stop. Oh, for God's sake, where is this? Oh, hold on a minute. What do you mean there's a... Wait, where is this riot? It seems like it was really spread out. Huh. Okay. So, let's see. I'm thinking it was a bit of a gang war, because we have red gang, green gang. It's definitely seeming like that might have been a bit of a gang war. Okay. Well, like I said, hopefully the yards help out with that a little bit, because it's just going to give them more space, right? Red gang right now owns this place, which we're going to clean up. Let's see what else they own. They own this yard, which we're going to clean up. They own this yard, which we're going to clean up, or that common room, rather. And do they own anything down here? They don't. Do they own this fight club? They do. Okay. So we're going to get all of that cleaned up, and hopefully, I mean, it's going to annoy Red Gang. 100%. They're going to be really upset about this, but it's my prison. It's that simple. It's my prison. They're not taking it over. They're not painting on the floors or painting on the walls or doing whatever they're doing. It's not how this works. I'm also thinking that given we keep getting this notification about narcotics, it might not be a bad idea to... Well, you know what would be nice? If I could go and shake down... Let's start with staff-only spaces, because we might as well see if we find anything in the staff-only spaces of the prison. I'm actually really curious about that. I've never done a staff-only shakedown before. And thus far, it seems like we're not going to find anything, which is good. Oh, no, hold on a minute. What do we find? What is this? What is that? It's a kicker and drinks. Okay, well, that's... I don't know what a kicker is. Is that like a... It kind of looks like a hacky sack. I'm honestly not sure. And then we have a normal shakedown going on as well, where suddenly we're finding a lot of things. Oh, man. All right. We might want to change our policy on certain things. So if you destroy something, locked down for 12 hours, that's fine. If you try to escape, solitary for 6 hours is fine. If you attack a prisoner, locked down for 6 hours. If you attack staff... I'm going to move that to lockdown for 24 hours. Serious injury is going to still be solitary. Intoxication is locked down for 6 hours. Murder is 3 days in solitary. If we found weapons, solitary for 6 hours. Tools, that. Drugs, that. Narcotics, that. I'm going to say drugs are going to be a lockdown for 6, maybe 8 hours. And if you produce narcotics, kind of a similar idea. Did we find a tunnel? Ooh, we did find a tunnel. Interesting. Okay. Let's get those out of here. And let's see, we'll see what the punishment ends up being from that. Oh, now this is interesting. It seems that Dumber here has broken out of his cell, murdered another prisoner, and murdered a guard. So let's just, turn on free fire just really, really quickly for a second there. And I'm going to send a few guards up this way, and we're going to see what happens to Mr. Dumber. Is what we're gonna do. So I think we missed with the taser. We have a sniper though. He just one-shot that guard. Interesting. That's very, very interesting to me. Now, can we deal with him? I think we tased him. Oh. Well, that's a little bit. I don't want to say I'm disappointed he's not dead, but I'm a little disappointed. I mean, mostly because I want to see what happens, right? To a gang when we. Well, serve justice upon their leader, right? That's all I was doing. I wasn't trying to murder him or nothing like that. I was just serving justice upon their leader. I don't know. I get the feeling he's not very happy in there, but he can stay there until the new facilities are built, which I think my priority is going to be Supermax. And I suppose once morning comes along, we could probably go ahead and get to work on the Supermax facility. So I suppose a Supermax facility is going to be considerably smaller than a full-size facility, and I suppose that's okay. We'll go for, let's say, 50 units this way, and we'll go for about 50 units down here as well, and that's going to be our giant corridor. Which, by the way, I realize this space needs more lights, because overnight it is ridiculously dark and it's a little bit silly, but this will be fine for here, and what we can do is go to pathways and just say that essentially, what size have we got the path over here? It is right from the doors, so essentially we're going to go from here, and we're going to go, I guess, like this, and that'll be our pathway, and that is 6 across. So what we can do is go 2 right here, we can go 6x6 right here. And then what we do is we have this thing, I suppose, go, let's see, 10 units from here. We want to go 2 on this side. So 1, 2, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 1, 2. We want to go 11 right there. And essentially, this is where the paths are going to split. And like I said, we'll go to the top and it's going to be, let's see, pathways. If we go to the top, this is going to be Supermax. And if we go to the bottom, that'll be protective custody. So there's a good chance these facilities are going to be mirrored. We don't necessarily have as much space up here as I'd like, but I think it'll be enough. It'll definitely be enough. Like I said, Supermax and protective custody, it's not going to be that many people. So it shouldn't really matter too much if we don't necessarily have the most amount of space. So we'll go another 10 units right there, and we'll go another 10 units right here, and we'll just bring this right up to that spot, bring this right up to that spot, and what we'll do is essentially just head this off right about there, and head it off right about there. And in terms of doors, I think we just go for something relatively simple. I think some doors in the middle, and some doors here as well. But what I think might be interesting is some doors off to the side like this, because in theory, we could have some additional sort of administration facilities off to the sides here. So prisoners come in through the middle, and then there's staff spaces on either side, sort of utility rooms and things like that. So that's my idea for bringing people through here towards their facilities. Now, in terms of the general layout of this, obviously, these are all going to be perimeter walls up until about this point. So let's just go ahead and plan out some perimeter walls for the rest of this space, which is obviously going to go around the entire length of the map, which is okay. We kind of need this. It does stop prisoners from making a break for it as much as they'd like to do. So something like this, and then this guy wants the autosaves done. Oh, that is an awful, awful noise. Once the autosave's done, we can bring this. That is such an awful noise. Oh, I've never noticed just how it sounds like fingers being scraped on a chalkboard. It's a really unpleasant sound. Oh man, it's not so bad when you're just building like this. I'll be honest, it's not that big of a deal. But when the game hitches for a second whilst autosaving and you're placing a wall, the sound just loops and it feels like it amplifies, and it's a little bit rough, but that's fine. So I think what we'll do here is actually have this open into a yard, perhaps? Or, well, what about? What if I went, say, 15 units there, and I go 15 units there? What length is this? So that is now 32. So if I do 32 by, say, 20, and then what I can do is sort of this right here. So my idea is this is sort of going to be a walkway. Like, it's going to be a path around a yard. It's going to be outdoors. And then this part here is going to be inside a building. So it's essentially two separate walkways that will kind of surround this space. One of them is going to be staff only and indoors. The other one is where new prisoners are going to come in. So I think that'll be kind of interesting. It might be a little bit weird looking, but I sort of like this idea. And I suppose what we can also do is sort of set this up like an airlock, right? So prisoners come through here, staff can sort of go around that way. And this is going to be their yard. So if I just go ahead and continue with the walls, essentially this is all going to be open space, and the fenced in part is going to be, well, the central part is going to be a yard. So all of this is open, this is the yard, and that's okay. And then in terms of things that the prisoners are going to need, let me use objects here to mark out my midpoints. So this is the midpoint right there. So let's put a door right about there. And we'll put some doors sort of down at the bottom sides here. In fact, you know what? We're not going to do that. We're going to keep this all walled in. The yard's going to have one way in and one way out, because there's not really anything down here for the prisoners anyway. And this is going to be how they get access to other things. So essentially, if we go, say, 10 units here, 10 units here, we could probably say that this space is a canteen. We could continue this staff corridor and say that this space across the way is perhaps a kitchen. And that way we can say that we have staff doors, such as, these ones here, somewhere like that and somewhere like that. So staff are able to use these corridors to move around the supermax facility, crossing their own corridor to get into the canteen where they can feed the prisoners. And then for entrance to the canteen itself, we can do maybe just a nice double door there. And then across the way, I think what we could do is perhaps maybe a laundry and cleaning cupboard. Maybe that's what we do here. And I think I'm just going to sort of do those in one space. So essentially, something like this. We'll go for doors, and it's going to be this and this. So this is laundry, this is cleaning, it's all accessed from the one door. This is the canteen, which means prisoners generally just use this corridor, which is fine by me. And what we can also, ooh, hello, I might have clicked on something. What we can also do is bring this up here, and we can say that there's going to be a staff door right about there. So staff will have access to the laundry and cleaning space from their own corridor. They don't need to go through the main part of the prison, and I think that's probably for the best. So I like that. I think that's pretty good. We could potentially also, what is this, 8x11? We could do another 8x11 space right here. And that could essentially be a staff room. It's not the biggest staff room, but it could be one, and I think that's probably fine. Oh, that's a problem. What are all you doing? And where is this riot? Oh, it's going to be in there again, isn't it? Are we dealing with it? We're dealing with it. Okay, so that's fine. So that's what I think this space could sort of be. And I do think we could... What am I clicking on that's bringing me over here? I think I'm clicking on these the notifications that keep popping up. But essentially, I think we could maybe do a bunch of staff rooms sort of down the sides like this. So these corridors actually do sort of serve a bit of a purpose. And then maybe some staff doors like this as well. So this little bit is sort of part of that corridor. And then maybe what we do is, let's see. So laundry, cleaning, canteen. What else do they need? I keep clicking on things. What else are they going to need? Well, they're going to need cells, obviously. That's kind of a given. So maybe what we do is we go back to doors and we sort of head off the staff corridors just there. And maybe, can I avoid clicking on another thing? I clicked on it again. Maybe what we do is this becomes sort of a joint corridor right there. So in terms of doors, we're maybe going to want to get maybe some normal doors just there for a bit of added security. And maybe we do the same here as well. Just sort of have these airlock things everywhere. Just so things are a little bit safer. We've also discovered a gang leader. Not bad. Oh, hello. What is this? We've identified a dealer in gang territory. A large sum of money was confiscated from them. What, $500? That's a large sum of money, I guess. I mean, it is, to be fair. I guess it was this guy. That's unfortunate, fella. You hate to see it. And so I think for now, this is roughly what I'm looking for out of a Supermax facility. It's relatively basic, but my thinking is this is a yard, this is a canteen, this is laundry, and this is a cleaning cupboard. This will be a staff room, this here will be a kitchen. This right here could be a common room, this over here could be a shop. We could have a library, we could have other things that they need. Let me have a look over here. What is it? What else do they need? They need maybe a gym, for example. They could have a chapel. Basically, we have the space, if we want to use it, to allow the prisoners to have a chapel and a gym and cleaning cupboards and all of that. They're not going to have a workshop up here, but honestly, there's probably not going to be enough of them to warrant having a workshop. And we don't have that many cells either, of course, because we're probably not going to have that many people up here. But it should be enough. We should have space for security. We can, of course, put door servos and things like that in here as well. But I think this will be pretty good for the makings of a Supermax facility. I'm going to put another door right there just to really reinforce the idea of all these sort of airlocks that we have around here, just to make sure this place is as secure as it can possibly be. These are actually the staff corridors that I'm securing right there. We don't really need to be securing those too much. But I think here, for example, we can probably secure that quite a bit. And maybe this bit as well. Just because we can, we'll secure that bit as well and see what ends up happening. So that's essentially going to be the Supermax thing. I might put some guard towers in the corners of the yard, which is the only outdoor space they're going to have. We have these open spaces up here where I might put armed guards or something like that. It doesn't really matter. And we have plenty of space for guards and staff to walk around safely away from everybody. It's kind of just a matter of getting this place built first, because it's still very much a work in progress. I don't think the building itself has actually gone up yet. I think they're still very much working on getting that going, so that's fine by me. It's not a huge deal. We'll get there. So while all of that's going on the east side of the prison, I totally forgot to come back here and sort out the new yards. So let's go ahead and get that done. Let's get a yard right there. Let's extend it the entire way through there, and let's do the same thing over here as well. We're also seeing a little bit of rioting, a little bit of casual rioting here and there, but that's probably fine. Not gonna worry too much about that one. What we'll do though is go into deployment, and make sure... Oh, there it is. Oh, and it's over. Okay, yeah, a little bit of casual rioting. When do they have free time? So 9 a.m. until 7 p.m., essentially, is when we need people in these yards. So, essentially right here, I guess. Let me just double check something. Yeah, dedicated yard time in the middle of the day. Okay, so what we'll do is go and do 1, 2, 3, 4 guards just generally assigned to these spaces. And we might want to do, unless we have them patrolling down here, which it doesn't look like we do, we might want to go and say perhaps 3 guards assigned to these yards during those times as well. And then during this time, I'm sure there's patrols, but we'll go for 3, we'll go for 4, we'll go for 3, and we'll go for 4. And then what I want to do is make sure that we do have a patrol that sort of goes up and down this path, and that also goes up and down this path right here. So we'll go ahead and assign 2 guards right there, and we'll assign 2 guards right there. And the same during yard time, we'll go for 2 guards, and we'll go for 2 guards. And that should keep us pretty good. That should keep us okay. And then in terms of things for the inmates to do, we'll go ahead and put some bleachers, and we'll make these relatively symmetrical, so some bleachers right there as well. We could give them some benches, perhaps, or some small benches at the very least. Although I mostly want to give them things to actually do. Place in the corners of yards and open areas for guards and armed guards to watch over your prisoners. Assign guards via deployment increases the level of suppression in that area. Guards are sheltered from the weather. Interesting. Okay, I mean, this is something I feel I should be... I feel like I should be using this more. I've got to be honest, it's a very mean-looking building, and I do kind of enjoy what it looks like. I've got to be honest. It's pretty cool looking. I wonder if I could put this thing. Well, I mean, we could just try here, I suppose. Let's give that a shot. We'll put the guard pavilions in those corners, and we'll go and do sort of the same thing just here. And the same thing just here as well. We'll get those installed. And then for the yards themselves, let's do... I'm going to do a couple of outdoor tables, I think, just again to give the prisoners somewhere to sort of sit and relax a little bit. And then in terms of things to actually do, let's give them some phones across there. And we'll give them some phones across here as well. And we can start using the phone taps that we have. We could also give them some weights benches, I suppose. So we'll go for 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 of them. And we'll do the same at the top end as well. We'll flip them around and go, I guess, 1, 2, 3. Wait, how did I think it was like this, right? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 of them. Are these guys weirdly spaced out? Oh, they are. I see. This guy isn't supposed to be there. That guy's supposed to be more like there. Okay, so that gives us spacing right there. In terms of other things, we could give them a punching bag, I suppose. Give them something to take their frustrations out on. So, a couple of punching bags. And what else have we got? I suppose lights wouldn't hurt. A couple of floodlights right there. Maybe a couple of floodlights at the top end as well. And what else? Maybe tire apparatus so they can climb a little bit. And I think that'll be good enough for now. I'm not really too interested in making this thing too crazy, but I do want to make sure it's done and working. Now, at the very least, we do have prisoners coming in to use the toilets, which is good news. That does mean that those are working and doing what we want them to do, so that's going to help the prisoners be a little bit more relaxed. And apparently gangs have demands? The Vipers, increase regime yard time to 3 hours. Interesting. I didn't know gangs could demand things. That's... Wait, how... You're demanding from your... you're demanding from in there, are you? Oh, I don't know about that, fella. I don't know that we're going to be, I don't know that we're going to be listening to that request. I mean, honestly, we are very close to having this finished. which, by the way, turned out to be super expensive. We were sitting at about $200,000, and when it came to placing all the furniture, it just cost me $200,000 to buy everything for this building. So this building is so expensive. It is so expensive. It's kind of ridiculous, but it's coming along. The building itself is done. A lot of the furniture is being installed. It's just going to take a while, and that's okay. So for the most part, I think we're doing all right. I really do. I think, you know, we've got these yards with the bathrooms and all the stuff for the prisoners to do. Once the yards are built, I'm hoping it spreads them out a little bit further and stops some of the aggression. It might. It might not. It might completely backfire, but I'm willing to give it a shot, and I'm hoping for the best. So I suppose what we'll do is, between this episode and the next one, I'll go ahead and I'll get this finished, and honestly, I'll go ahead and build this as well. We'll get this thing sorted, we'll get it up and running, and next time we'll start to move prisoners into this new space, which I think is going to be very, very exciting. So that's going to do us for today. Thank you for watching, everybody. It's been an absolute pleasure, as always. And as always, I'll see you next time. Buh-bye!